Hi, I'm Dr. David Dobson. Welcome to Conversations. Today, my guest is Dr. Atieh Poushneh. Atieh is an assistant professor of digital marketing at California State University, Bakersfield. She received her PhD in marketing from the University of Texas, Rio Grande Valley. Her research interests are consumer psychology, artificial intelligence, augmented reality, virtual reality, and human-robot interaction. Today, we will be discussing the effect of interactive technologies on users' behavior. It's a pleasure to have you on my show, Atia.
Hello, Dr. Dobson. Thank you for inviting me.
Atia, what are interactive technologies?
So, interactive technologies are interactive, which means that user or consumers have control over their interaction with technology. So there are different types of interactive technology in marketing. Examples are augmented reality, virtual reality, artificial intelligence, and there are so many interactive technology.
Nice. Just to ensure our viewers understand various interactive technologies terms, could you explain like augmented reality, virtual reality, mixed reality, anything related to this interactive technologies?
Augmented reality is a type of interactive technology that projects three-dimensional virtual content onto the present reality and enriches user experience about the present reality. So there are so many augmented reality mobile applications in the market, and user or consumer can download the augmented reality application on their devices, and they can see, for example, in the context of online shopping, they can see how a virtual product looks in their own real place. For example, if a consumer wants to buy a pair of eyeglasses or sunglasses with the aid of augmented reality mobile application, they can download the application. The camera of the smart device can scan their face and add a pair of eyeglasses on their face. So they can make a purchase decision with more certainty and less risk, and they can see how for example, glasses look on their face without being in a physical store. So this is augmented reality. And also, on the other hand, virtual reality, which is different from augmented reality, virtual reality with it requires a headset, VR headset, and it allows user to fully or completely immerse in a 3D virtual world and interact with digital content in the digital space. But in augmented reality, consumers or user can interact with the three-dimensional or 3D virtual content in the present reality.
Okay. Atia, how is artificial intelligence, AI, transforming interactive technologies?
So artificial intelligence is intelligence given to a machine in order to copy intelligent human behavior and human visual appearance. So artificial intelligence is expanding rapidly. There are different types of artificial intelligence in markets. We have voice-based artificial intelligence, avatars, chatbot. So one of the very simple example of artificial intelligence is Amazon Alexa or Apple Siri. Then it allows user to use their own voice and interact technology. So it influences the consumer behavior, and because it uses voice, user voice, it utilizes natural language processing. It can detect or identify user language style, a speech pattern. It understands user input, and based on the user questions, it generates response. And some of the artificial intelligence is more advanced. It can generate empathetic response. It means that it identifies the user feeling and emotion, and based on user emotion, it can generate their responses. Some of them can show sympathy and compassion to consumers.
Atia, how is the use of these interactive technologies influencing human behavior?
Artificial, one of the interactive technology, for example, augmented reality and artificial intelligence, both of them have both positive and sometimes negative aspects that influence consumer behavior. So for example, augmented reality can generate personalized responses based on user input. One of the factor that in augmented reality is information privacy. User have to share their own personal information in with technology in order to receive personalized responses. So it may so consumer maybe they are less likely to use augmented reality because of the information privacy, because of the information privacy violation. Another one is so interactive technologies such as augmented reality influences user behavior. It can generate personalized responses based on user input. For example, when augmented reality generates personalized responses for consumers, it requires you to have access to user personal information, such as their location or their pictures. So sometimes users are not willing to share their information. So one of the factors is information privacy. And another factor in interactive technology is sense of control. User wants to have control over their interaction with the technology. And it's a basic psychological needs, and user wants to have control. So interactive technology can be motivating and sometimes discourage consumers from using technology if it depends on the features in technology.
Could you share how interactive technologies you just mentioned, like augmented reality and virtual realities, are enhancing consumer digital experiences?
It's This technology, interactive technology, influences user experience. In the case of augmented reality, it enriches user experience in different ways. Because it can project three-dimensional virtual content onto the present reality, consumers can interact with the virtual content and they can see the virtual content. They don't need to imagine how a virtual product looks on them on the real place, and the technology bring the virtual content onto the present reality. It reduces cognitive load. It reduces psychological distance between virtual product and also consumers. It facilitates information processing and decision making. So it enriches the user experience about the present reality. So it enhances experience, and consumers would like to try or use this type of technology.
Atieh, as you mentioned, there is a potential of interactive technologies to elicit positive changes and definitely in for consumer experiences. So my question is, so why is their adoption is not widespread?
The adoption of the technology. So there are different conceptual framework in the literature that shows why people adopt technology or why they prevent from using technology. So some of them are ease of use of technology, convenience, usefulness, or usability of the technology. And also privacy is another variables that may discourage consumers from using or adopting technology, or complexity is another one. And also, as I mentioned, perceived control, where people, as the level of interactivity in technology increases, people would like to have control over their interaction with technology. And so in order to accept or embrace technology, consumers tend to want to have control over their interaction with technology because they want to be autonomous decision maker, and they want to have control.
Atieh, in your recent work, you looked into the effect of semi-human AI on perceived airiness and consumers' purchase intention. Can you share what you learned in this study?
Companies embed human-like traits or characteristics into artificial intelligence and humanized AI. It facilitates interaction with consumers or human. So in that research, I use interaction modality in order to humanize artificial intelligence. So AI is expanding, and it has been developing different form. So there are avatars, digital human, meta human, voice-based AI. So there are so many different types of artificial intelligence. So in that research, the research shows that how voice-based AI is perceived versus text-based AI, and how Voice-based AI is perceived more autonomous, more confident, and how those characteristics influences perception of eagerness and purchase intention. So based on uncanny valley effect, so there are different sources for uncanniness or eeriness. One of them is that if there is a subtle imperfection between the human-like appearance and human-like behavior, and people may perceive. Or another reason is that if AI is perceived too human-like, people perceive it eerie. So there should be a balance between human-like trait, or the level of the humanness in AI should be discussed before developing artificial intelligence in order to be accepted or used by consumers.
Atieh, how do you see the future of interactive technologies in digital space?
Interactive technology, artificial intelligence, for example, or augmented reality. And so they are digital marketers, or it is personalizing digital marketing. I know we see virtual influencers that promote the product on social media. So there are different type of artificial intelligence, and company use or adopt those technology into their businesses. For example, voice shopping or voice commerce is one of the example of AI that allows shoppers or user to use their own voice and search for the product, order the product. Another example is augmented reality features in the website or mobile application. So online user or online shoppers can see a three-dimensional image of the product in their space. It allows them to experience an image, and also some of the augmented reality is more advanced. It generates recommended feature. It recommends the products before they make a purchase decision. For example, in the case of sunglasses or eyeglasses, some of the augmented reality applications provides measurement feedback. It is scanned.
Atia, what is your advice to marketing students who are interested in interactive technologies?
I think the interactive technology, such as augmented reality or virtual reality, metaverse, virtual influencer, artificial intelligence, are expanding, and they need to stay updated, and they focus on a specific area in interactive technology because it's expanding so rapidly. And when I started my dissertation about augmented reality a few years ago, there was like augmented reality, but now we have metaverse, virtual reality, avatars, and digital human, meta human. So it's expanding.
Thank you for your time and sharing your work, Atia.
Thank you. Thank you so much.